Lord Captain, we're nearly to the Baron border.
So we are.
It troubles him, too.
Orders may be orders, but this... this goes too far.
Lord Captain!
We are the Red Wings, the pride of Baron! Must we now be thieves, sent to plunder from the weak?
Enough.
But Lord Captain!
The Mycidians offered no resistance, and still we cut them down.
Listen to me. We did no more than what our kingdom's peace and prosperity required us to do. The Mycidians knew too much of the crystal and its secrets. His Majesty deemed it so. We are the Red Wings of Baron. It is not our place to question the orders of our king.
Lord Captain.
Lord Captain! Monsters at the fore!
Everyone all right?
Aye.
With all these monsters as of late.
Disturbing, is it not? I wonder what it bodes.
We've reached the castle, my lord.
Well then, prepare for landing, men.
My lord!
Thank you.
Your Majesty, what's become of you? Where is the noble knight, the man who took me in as an orphan and raised me as his own? The strong, just king I once knew. Is a crystal worth all this? Robbing a peaceful people of what's theirs by right. What need could be so great? King's orders or no, there's no forgiving what we've done.
Cecil? Won't you tell me what happened? First you're sent off to Mysidia, and now to hunt some beast again so soon? Did something happen in Mysidia?
No, it's nothing.
Then why won't you look at me?
In Mysidia, we stole a crystal from people who had done no wrong. I've worn this darkened armor for so long now, there's no mote of light left in me. Not even in my heart.
You're a good man, Cecil.
I'm a coward. A coward who cannot even defy orders he knows he ought not follow.
Cecil of the Red Wings is many things, but he is no coward. Not the Cecil who I love. The king is sending you to Mist to slay the Eidolon, isn't he? If anything were to happen to you, I couldn't...
Kane will be with me. I'll be fine. It's late. You should get some rest.
Be careful.
Thank you, Rosa. But I know what I've become.
Shall we then, Cecil?
I'll be counting on you, my friend.
Then you've nothing to fear.
Mother, you can't die just because your dragon did it.
I've heard of their lot. Men who can conjure Eidolons. Summoners.
Then the dragon we slew was her mother's?
You're the ones who killed her dragon?
Forgive us. We've no idea this would happen to your mother.
His Majesty sent us to eliminate every last one of these people.
No!
Foul work, to be sure. We'll need to kill the girl as well.
Cain!
It's her or us, Cecil.
She's a child!
You'd betray your king?
Betray him? Any man who'd wish for this is no king of mine!
I thought you might say that.
Then...
I owe His Majesty much, but not so much I'd soil the Dragoon's name in his.
Then you're with me.
Baron's army is the mightiest in the world. Our flight means nothing if we remain alone. We must treat with other nations, share what we've seen. And Rosa, she must share our flight.
And she will, thank you.
I'm not doing this for you.
Huh?
Quickly, we mustn't linger here. What of the girl?
We take her with us. Come, it's not safe here. Take my hand.
No!
We've no time. Use force if you must.
Stay away!
Wait!
Leave me alone! I hate you!
Thank you. Oh, Anna! There's life left in you yet.
Father. Edward. He is the Prince of Dampsian. He disguised himself as a bard to avoid attention. Forgive me, Father, for running off with him. Edward, I'm in love with him, Father. But I could not stay without my father's blessing. I was about to return when...
The Red Wings laid siege to us, led by a man named Golbez.
Golbez?
Yes. A figure clad in armor of deepest night, his strength beyond that of mortal man.
And the Red Wings' purpose?
Our crystal. And then they rained fire upon us. I lost my mother and father. Then Anna tried to shield me from their arrows.
You love this man that much?
Father, please, forgive me. I was so selfish. Edward, I love you.
Anna!
Anna! Anna! This Golbez, tell me more of him.
I've heard he came to Baron only recently. It seems he's using the Red Wings to steal crystals.
Tears do not bring back the dead, boy. Anna's death must be avenged. I'll find this Golbez.
Tella, not alone.
She was not your daughter. Her killer will die by my hand.
Anna!
Coward. You're a man, aren't you? A grown man! Stop crying. I have.
Rydia.
You're right. I'm nothing but a coward, just as you say. That's why I'm just going to stay at Anna's side. It doesn't matter anymore. Nothing does!
You're not the only one who's grieving. Anna would not wish to see you fawning like a fool. Please, I've desperate need of your help right now.
But how could I help you?
My name is Cecil. A friend of mine has taken ill with desert fever in Kaipo and needs a sand pearl if she is to live. And for that, I've need of your aid.
You need my aid?
I do. Rosa's life depends on it. I beg you.
This woman you speak of, she means a great deal to you, doesn't she? As Anna did. As Anna did to me. In a cave far to the east dwells a monstrous creature known as an antlion. The pearls you seek form from the fluid the beast secretes as it lays its eggs in the sand. There is no overland route to its den. We must cross the northern shoals to get there. A hovercraft is docked here. With it we can reach the creature's cave. It can bear us across the surf to Kaipo as well. Come. We must hurry. Farewell, my love.
I can be with you but for this moment. The spirit calls me onward to become a part of it again.
Don't leave me, Anna!
Edward, you must be brave. Golbez cannot be allowed to have the crystals. You gave your love to me once. Now share it with all the world.
Anna, my love. I will try. But what would you have me do?
We'll be right back.
this?
Clad like that? That's a monk of Fabul.
We'll be right back.
pain. Even you now?
Let me ease your suffering.
You'll do nothing!
Stop!
Rosa.
Kane, tell me you've not turned traitor.
Don't look at me.
Kane, why do you now hesitate?
Gulbez! You're him, the usurper.
So, you are Cecil. Allow me to give you something. A gift to remember our meeting.
Cecil!
Let me through!
I did not come to treat you well. Ah! Kane, enough of this foolishness. Bring me your crystal.
My lord.
Don't do it, Kane!
Rosa, let it be.
Oh, you care for this one, too. Then let me take her along as well. To hold in trust until we are gracing the chance to meet again. Come, Kane.
It would seem your life is spared for now.
Kane, wait!
Thank you.